This is part 2 of Fungdrew's story. Part 1 is up here for the people who are new, and in short summary of what happened last time, we barely managed to scrape together enough money to be able to get out of this town filled with snobby and power-hungry rich people who discriminate against us mushroom people. In other words, we got the cash, now we need to get the hell out, which Fungdrew and his mushroom friend were sure as hell planning, but the guard decided, nah, these people need to experience racism. Basically, they're being subjected to the equivalent of random security checks at an airport, so they aren't let out, to which some random woman comments on, saying that y'all aren't trying to purchase my boats, are you?
What the fuck is, what is that?
5 silver ain't gonna get you nowhere, pal. To which he asks, these are your boats, right? We can pay you a little bit now and somewhere later, you know what I'm saying? And then she goes, I was about to go on an adventure myself. Maybe I can take you with me. So Fungdrew of course says, yes, please. But you didn't think it was gonna be as easy as this, right? Thou shalt be tested, she said. Probably. And at that point, we were split into 2 groups of 3 and sent into mortal combat with each other in the middle of town. But since Fungdrew is an absolute unit, he says that they should focus 1 unit of the enemy team. ADIQ Warrior officially no longer super retarded, but now just really retarded. Due to Fungdrew's superior planning, they win the fight without any problems, and the enemy team loses its spot for the expedition in place for Team 81 IQ. The leader also gets insulted for causing this brawl in the middle of town, but that's not so important. What is important is that the woman we just got hired by is the pusher, and she is sending us to the Tundra, the most dangerous place in all of God's home. The preparations of the most life-threatening part of Fungdrew's life ever is starting, and he just pulled his lucky card. A tailor willing to make him clothes for just his 5 remaining silver. Crazy, because Fungdrew is now officially dripped the fuck out and ready for the Tundra's cold, and the expedition finally starts. That is after solving some problems with a guard who wanted to line his own pockets with fees for passing the town's gate, even though the pusher said we didn't have to pay. But hey, he's Lord Iron Fist's son. Did I mention Iron Fist said we didn't have to pay? Whatever, here goes. Having finally made it through the frigid snowstorms and dangerous terrains of the Tundra, they found a library that would provide them with some respite from the cold they had to endure. Fungdrew immediately started goofing off, trying to make potions of course. Meanwhile, the pusher and their foreman were discussing serious matters, which our ADIQ warrior of course chose to completely ignore. Eventually he got the idea, yo Fung Fung, we need to totally spar, we gotta like, get stronger and stuff, yeah. And Fung Fung was like, bro, for sure, man. So they started fighting until the pusher had to intervene because they decided those serious matters should finally be brought to everyone so they could find out what is going on and prepare. Turns out, a woman they had met along their journey in the Tundra had threatened one of their lives. This would not go unpunished. She belongs to some sort of cult or something. So they decided that they had to gear up. The pusher had the idea that Fungdrew and the gang should be allowed to carry weapons, but getting weapons would still take a while. Very soon, they already had to leave the library to escape the Tundra. They were not safe. They had gotten the ores and minerals they came here for, and they were all paid generously under their pusher's command. Fungdrew is now extremely fond of the pusher and would fight for her life, but he does not know what she has really done. Who is the pusher? Who are we protecting? What is she hiding? What even is her name? You didn't actually think I'd leave this video here, did you? You should have seen the length of this video. This is fucking insane. Do you even know how many hours of footage I had to sift through to make this video? I said video a lot. Oh well, here goes. So she starts off saying her name in history. Her name is Rosenthal Vetrian. Turns out, she is the ancestor of a healer who tried healing this town. Turns out, her ancestors are pretty shit at healing, as the entire townspeople have turned to stone, and the disease is still spreading. Good job. She also tells them that they should never dare speak of it. So guys,
don't say her name, I will get angry.
She then tells the others to also introduce themselves since they were so adamant on finding out who she is. Kaladin is the foreman, basically a little slave protector guy thing. Cedric is just a regular dude. Fungdrew is Fungdrew. Fungfung is Fungfung. Yeah, I don't know. Then they head back to town. After having gotten to know each other and realizing that Tundra really didn't faze him, Fungdrew decides his old clothes wouldn't do it anymore. He'd get a tailor to make him some big boy scroomy armor. He plans first to get the clothing from his original tailor, but that tailor had things to attend. He couldn't wait, and an old senile, well, he first thought scam artist, overheard the conversation and decided that he could get the clothes made. Fungdrew gives him money and he's gone? What the? Bro, that sucks. Anyway, next expedition's planned and ingredients. Boy, I got many, let me tell you that. Vint? What's that? Sure, what's the harm in that? What could go wrong?
Shh, Rosenthal, everything is okay.
Hey, buddy, wake up!
I can drive. How you doing, my friend? Hey, don't touch me, I have a wife.
We'll teach him a lesson.
Now, there you go.
Not now, Funky.
Anyone ever told you you've got nice hair?
Please let him sober up. He's telling the truth. Please, just give me time.
Said nothing's wrong.
You need Stop. To drink.
Funky, dude,
hurt.
Get over here.
Ah, my head.
Well, that's Deadlands for you.
Kill it! And now the rest. We got work to do.
Chat, is this peak Deadlands roleplay? Anyway, after slaughtering all those monsters, the pusher was still sorting out deals. Suspicions were rising as they are thinking that the dealer has ties with the cult that is stalking Fungdrew's gang. As weapons are drawn and threats are made, yeah, he ran. Of course he ran. There are 5 stinky mercenaries in front of that guy. And now let me tell you, he was fast. We gave relentless chase, but his unnatural speeds held us at bay as we followed him through desert and jungle and lost his tracks. There, we came across an old church structure. Not much to be said about it, as nothing seemed to be happening. So, they left and went to inspect the other parts of the jungle. There, they came across a patch of mushrooms arranged in a circular fashion. Not the color of our mushroom's cap. Ours is red.
What the hell?
After experimenting around a little bit, they get back to Iron Fist. Bahola, Kerr. That's the woman from the cult. The cult. The cult that is searching for us. Pusher and the foreman will piece of the fuck up in the tundra, Kerr. You already know South Side, bruh. We hate the tundra. So, since the pusher and the foreman went to fight that woman, it has been an extremely long time. And for some reason, the Lord of Iron Fist calls a feast. Something odd is going on. What causes there to celebrate? Wait, the woman? No, it can't be, right? There's no way she would have died, right? How could the cult's member be standing before us with the Lord calling for celebration? I mean, yes, the pusher does cause trouble for Iron Fist sometimes, but there's no way she could have died. Not them both. How is she here?
Be there or be square. Join Deadlands.